Hi, this video lecture is dedicated to Facebook and my friend late V. Suresh. It is because of Facebook that I came to know the whereabouts of my friend. After college life, we were not in touch and we were very busy building careers and all. During those days, there were no cell phones and all, no social sites also. So we were not in touch. But after a couple of years, you know, when I started searching about my friends, I couldn't find him. There were certain sites, Orkut and patchmates.com, and there were certain sites. But I couldn't find him anywhere. The day I joined Facebook, I came to know. I saw some of my college friends over there. I sent requests to them. Then I came to know about my friends, about my juniors, those who used to maintain an Excel sheet of all the friends they were coming in touch with. And from that Excel sheet, I got the phone number of one of my roommate, and from my roommate I came to know that V. Suresh is no more among us. Anyway, I'm very thankful to Mark Zuckerberg for making such a nice social site Facebook, and God bless you. And it is because of you that many of the guys of my age, those who are not in touch with their friends, because we didn't have such a nice communication that we have today. It is because of your social side that we are coming in touch with our old friends. Being a teacher, when I teach a group of students about website development, the website development can be in any of these three topics, PHP, JSP and .NET. By the end of the curriculum, I usually ask my students that, okay, let me know on what topic you want to make a practical website. So some of the students say that, sir, we want to make an online airline reservation system. And somebody says that, I want to make a site for my father, he is running some business. But at least one student out of each group I have seen, he asked me that he want to make a site like Facebook. You know, during that time I used to explain him that, see, Facebook is not made up of only PHP, it is made up of several modules. Some modules are made in Java, C++ and so many modules. It's a mix of several modules. So the natural query among students is that, sir, what are the modules that Facebook is made up of? So in this lecture, I'll tell you what are the modules that the Facebook is made up of. Facebook is working on several modules working together, but the main modules on which the Facebook is working on are 10. I'll start with one. The first module that Facebook works on is Thrift. What is Thrift? Thrift is a cross-language framework. You might be thinking that when Facebook is made up of PHP, then what is the need of the cross-language framework? See, PHP is used as a front-end, agreed. But for the chatting, airline software is used. Besides this, there are several small modules made in Java, C++ and many other languages. So, Thrift is used to make these modules made in different languages to intercommunicate, to be compatible with each other. So Thrift is a cross-language framework which is used in Facebook. Second is HipHop for PHP. See, the PHP code is converted to C++ through this HipHop for PHP. Why? Because the code of C++ is very highly efficient. It takes less space. Being less in size and quite efficient object code, it consumes less resources of web server, and obviously it becomes very fast. It runs very fast among servers. So the second module which Facebook uses is HipHop for PHP. The third module that Facebook uses is Haystack. Now what is Haystack? Haystack is an object store. It is highly scalable object store, and it is an object store with a high performance. And it is used for storing and fetching your profile pictures and the other pictures that you upload. So Haystack is an object store. I should make it clear that being an object store, it is not constrained to be used only with pictures. It can be used for storing other kinds of data also. The fourth module that Facebook uses is Varnish. Varnish is an HTTP accelerator. By the name only you can guess that it is used for accelerating the HTTP code among web servers. Besides this, it acts as a load balancer. It also caches the highly used pictures and photographs, you can understand that from accessing from the server or from the database, accessing from the cache is quite faster, right? So Vanish is used as an accelerator for quickly accessing the pictures and profile pictures and whatever the pictures you are using. The fifth module that Facebook uses is Scribe. Scribe is a log server system. Whatever activities we do on Facebook, commenting, writing posts, liking something, so these are all logged up, and these all things are logged up using this log server Scribe. Sixth module that Facebook uses is BigPipe. See, when you open a chat window or newsfeed or whatever, these are small web pages which are opened in separate sections. These web sections are called as pagelets. So to handle these small sections, see, these all chat windows and all these are independent of each other. And to handle these small web sections, BigPipe is used. What is BigPipe? It's a dynamic web page serving system and it manages your pagelets. The seventh module that Facebook uses is Cassandra. Cassandra is a distributed storage system. It is no SQL based storage system used for searching in your inbox, right? Now, what is no SQL storage system? See, when you say SQL storage system, SQL means SQL storage system, right? So the SQL storage system is based on relational database system. That means tabular format, right? When you say no SQL storage system, that means it doesn't use a relational database system. It uses some other technology for that. And as I said, Cassandra is used for your inbox searching. Eighth module is obviously your MySQL. MySQL being a very popular database system, Facebook uses it for storing certain data. But let me tell you, besides MySQL, Facebook uses the key value storage system also. Key value, if you remember, like if you have heard of hash table or dictionary system in your data structure subject, key and the value. With the help of the key, you access the value, right? This type of storage system is very optimistic. It takes up less memory and it is very highly portable among different database systems. So, besides MySQL, Facebook uses your key value storage system also for the storage. The ninth module that Facebook uses is Memcached. See, for accessing everything from the database, it takes a lot of time. See, whenever you request something, obviously web server accesses that thing from the database. But the frequently accessed things, whatever you are using very very frequently, Memcached system caches it. That means when that thing is required again, instead of accessing it from the database, web server uses it from the cache only to make it very fast. So what is Memcached? It's a distributed memory caching system to make the things faster. You must have seen that while working with Facebook, even during the peak hours, the server is quite fast, right? So it is because of this technology caching system and all that your Facebook works quite faster still. The 10th module that Facebook is using is XHProf. It's a PHP profiler system. XHProf is used for profiling the PHP in live mode, in live environment. And what's the job of this profiling system? It checks up the whole modules of PHP and removes the modules that are not being used. I mean, it discards the modules which are not being used or which are lesser used to keep the resources for the highly used PHP functions and modules, right? But let me tell you that PHP is not using only these 10 modules. PHP is keeping evolving day by day. New functions, new modules are being added to increase the features, to keep the speed, and you know, it is an ever-going process, right? I think you have got the answer of what are the main modules that Facebook is made up of. Thanks for watching the video. Have a nice day.